The internet is mankind's greatest tool. We can talk to anyone and buy anything at any time we want. Everyone loves to go on Netflix and social media whenever they want and without fees. This is because of net neutrality. Net neutrality is currently at risk of being lost to big internet companies. Today I'm going to be telling you what would happen if we lost net neutrality and how we can prevent it from being lost. To begin, I'm going to tell you what would happen if we lost net neutrality. According to Chad Sansing, an ed tech teacher, in his article on net neutrality in 2014, net neutrality is what keeps business fair on the internet. All internet sites have the same internet speed and cannot be discriminated against by ISPs or internet service providers. According to Matt Reynolds, a tech reporter, who wrote the article "Webfirms Are Right to Demand Net Freedom" in 2017. Between the years 2011 and 2013, Verizon and AT&T blocked the service Google Wallet because they supported a competing site. If net neutrality laws were to disappear, this would mean that any website that the ISP did not agree with could be blocked and you could not use it while on their internet. This means you could not see Netflix because they supported some other streaming site like Hulu. This means you could not use Twitter because they preferred Facebook. On October 2nd, 2017, the social media website Discord went down for everyone using Chart. There's huge backlash, and it was up the next day. But this is just a snippet of what would happen if internet companies had their way and could block whatever sites they wanted to. According to Simon Friedlander, a law journalist who wrote the article "Net Neutrality and the FCC's Open Internet Order" in 2016, internet companies would and could stop you from, would make you pay for viewing these sites up to $10 more a month. And not only that, they would be sold in different packages, such as a social media package or a video package. This would mean you would be paying more money to pay for, to use the stuff you use every day in your life right now. Currently, according to Guo Hong, a business professor, in his paper, Effects of Competition Among Internet Service Providers and the Net Neutrality Debate in 2017, the FCC, or the Federal Communications Commission, which has controlled the internet for 30 years, is currently trying to push a bill that will get rid of net neutrality laws. The chairman of the FCC is being backed by large internet companies such as Verizon to do this. This means that you could lose all your access to social media without having to pay for it. And companies like Amazon would have to charge you more because they would have to pay more to be able to use the internet. Now that I have told you what would happen if net neutrality was lost, I'm going to give you some solutions to prevent the loss of net neutrality. The first way you can help prevent the loss of net neutrality is to support website protests. According to Elizabeth Barber, a Time reporter, in the August edition of Time magazine in 2014, there were, the major protest date is July 17th. Within the week of July 17th, websites such as Amazon, Google, and Netflix slow down their connections and introduce pop-up ads to their websites to make it to simulate what it would be like without net neutrality laws. According to Audrey Hudson, an investigative journalist, in her article "Unusual Bedfellows Team Up to Fight Anti-Piracy Proposals" in 2012, these protests have worked before. In 2012, the government attempted to issue a law that stated, that was called the Anti-Piracy Bill, that would destroy online use of movies and TV shows, and completely getting rid of fair use, which allows for free critique of published work. Large website protests at the time made sure this bill did not pass, and it has not come back up ever since. If we support net neutrality protests right now, we will be able to preserve net neutrality and make sure it stays in the future. According to Reynolds' article, 6 million people have come out in support of net neutrality. If you share your opinion and help support website protests, we will be able to preserve net neutrality. Today I have told you about what would happen if we lost net neutrality and how to support protests, and that we should support protests of net neutrality. Net neutrality is one of the most important parts of our internet browsing experience. If we lost it, we would have to pay for everything we did, and we would have to deal with slow connections if we did not have the money. We can prevent the loss of net neutrality by supporting website protests and sharing your opinions with the government. Net neutrality is at risk of being lost to big internet companies. We cannot let mankind's greatest tool be lost to people who simply want more money.